Hi, this is Joe Glavin with Philadelphia Floor. Today we're going to discuss applying stain with a carpet pad. Applying stain with a carpet pad does two things. Keeps you off your knees and it gives you an even application of the stain. You want to sand the floors to NWFA specifications, including edging, sanding, and buffing, back it, tack it. Everything that you would normally do for a floor that you're going to stain, you'll do. Applying stain with a carpet pad attached to a buffer will require cutting in. You'll cut in under toe kicks and along carpet edges.
That's a good look for you.
Not just any piece of carpet will work. You want to make sure that the carpet you're going to use to apply stain, one, is the diameter of the buffer that you're going to drive it with. Two, it doesn't contain any Stain Master or Scotch Guard products in it. Otherwise, the stain that you're pouring onto the pad will fly out and make a mess. You also want to make sure that you attach the pad to the back of a Scotch-Brite pad. It could be red or white, doesn't matter. A little spray adhesive to one side of the carpet pad and one side of the Scotch-Brite pad will keep it together and allow the drive block on the buffer to drive the pad with the stain on it. Here we're pouring about 8 to 10 ounces of a quick dry oil modified stain. We're applying this stain to a number one common white oak wood floor. And as you can see, the edges have been cut in. Simply a matter of pouring on the product, flipping the pad over, place the buffer on it. This is 175 RPM buffer, and apply the stain. As far as coverage, you'll probably get between 150 and 200 square feet per quart of stain. And this is non-VOC compliant stain. So plan on anywhere from 150 to 200 square feet per quart. You can see you get a very even coat of stain here. Blends in well with the edges that are already cut in. Applying stain in this manner can change the color that the stain is going to be. So if you have sampled your customer and you're going to use this method, just be sure that according to how you have the floor screened, if you need to water pop it, all of those things so that you get the same color that were in your samples. The dry time on the stain is really going to depend on what the manufacturer says on the can. This particular stain should have been dry in 2 to 3 hours. Don't be surprised if the stain is dry. The buffer does generate a little heat and the spread rate that you're getting with the stain will allow the stain to dry a little faster. So the finish system that you're going to use on top of the stain will also designate what the dry time is going to be, whether that's 4, 6 hours, 12 hours, or overnight. To purchase any carpet pads, buffer pads, or stains, go to phillyfloor.com.